NVIDIA versus AMD. Both companies have shown their latest cards. We've got the 1080, the 1070, and from AMD, the RX 480. But Evan, if I start with you, if I want the single fastest graphics card, I'm gonna have to go with the 1080, right? There's really no competition from AMD?
There isn't, no, there isn't, yeah. You know, when NVIDIA came out and presented these fantastic graphics cards, the 1080 and the slightly better value 1070, AMD came back with a $200 GPU. So, you know, I think that kind of says it. If you want the best performance, you've got to go with NVIDIA.
Al, you're shaking your head.
Okay, sure, it's $200. But they've already made clear in Crossfire, when you put two of them together, it will beat the 1080 on performance. And to be honest, for $200, it's still going to be cheaper. Two of them is still going to be cheaper than either the GTX 1080, potentially even the 1070. So you're getting bang for your buck and performance.
Who uses Crossfire? Not only do the very few people use Crossfire, also, it doesn't often work. You know, there are issues with games. A lot of games aren't compatible. It doesn't work with VR. So, you know, you can only use one GPU with VR. So it's not as the case of saying, oh, two of them together are better than this one really strong, really powerful graphics card. What you've also got to say is, you know, when AMD announced it, they decided to pick I can't even remember the game because it's so obscure to reference the benchmarks, as opposed to picking, I don't know, Crysis 3 or Battlefield or something that someone's actually heard of.
Ashes of Singularity.
Oh, that's it.
I'm going to call shenanigans on that as well. Okay, yes, it was a very, very niche game, but the reason they chose it is clear. It was so they can show off the best thing they have, asynchronous computing, which NVIDIA still doesn't have. And that'll work on any game that's DirectX 12 or Vulkan, which, let's face it, are the future of PC gaming. So more and more games will be working on that. It's just that, in fact, at the moment, there aren't many. That's why they chose
the game. At the moment, there's one.
Well, there's more than one, but yeah, there's not many. I'll give you that.
But will the Vulkan API, be enough to sort of come over the, you know, the performance, the raw specs that the 1080 offers compared to the RX 480?
Well, we haven't had the RX 480s end specifications given to us yet, so that is a big question. But the fact that it was able to play that game at, I think it was around 60 frames per second, is pretty darn impressive. And I'm just going to bring it back to, it's $200. $200 and able to do that. I mean,
yeah, it's $200, and then you kind, you know, they've married that with $200 VR. And then you kind of go, okay, so $200 for a graphics card, that's brilliant. And then I have to spend, you know, £700, £800 on a VR headset anyway. So people that are going to be spending that probably aren't bothered about just spending $200 on a graphics card. They might say, oh, you know what, I want to have the best performance here anyway, so I'm going to spend a little bit more. So again, I don't really see why that was the marketing message that was pushed, the VR, because it's flavor of the month, but was there any point in that really?
Yeah, okay, maybe that is flavor of the month, but the fact is, it will still do solid performance for regular gaming on top of that. I mean, we've already, as you've talked about, seen one game doing it, and for $200, if it comes even close in a single of matching the 1070, which it could do if you look at the number of computing units it has in it. I mean, we need more information, but if it comes even close to it, it is bang for your buck and it will meet most PC gamers' needs, and it will be ideal choice for anybody who wants to have an affordable rig.
So it seems all about price versus performance, bang for buck. And you say that people who want to get into VR might want to just, you know, they're not bothered about how much they're going to spend, but it could be £400 cheaper than like a 1080. So it really is a much lower barrier to entry for VR. And do you not think that would be good just, you know, for VR to make it more mainstream?
I think it will be. But don't forget, NVIDIA haven't announced their sort of lowest entry-level cards. So, you know, 1040 or 1050, these are going to come out and they're going to be competitive with AMD's offering. Now, the thing is, you know, when you want to present, right, I've got this fantastic new technology, smaller manufacturing process, it's really powerful. You don't go in at the lowest, you know, you go in at the highest when you're announcing things. And for me, that suggests that AMD might not quite have what it takes at the top.
No. You see, they've done all the background work to be great at the top as well. I think they've just done this as a sensible move to, you know, be the only person at that point in the market. They spotted nobody was there yet, but that's where they went to the bottom. It's what Motorola did with the Moto G back in the day, and they've just pulled a canny trick doing it. But if you look at Polaris, the work with Vulkan, if you look at their new Crimson Editions, you know, driver software, they've got everything at the back end coming through to be really competitive in the top end as well.
If you want top performance, you've got to go with NVIDIA at the moment. AMD still haven't shown any of their cards yet. And for me, I think that means that there might not be quite competitive at the top end, which is why they've gone, right, let's go at the bottom.
So what's the future? What do you think we'll see from the rest of 2016 or perhaps early into 2017? What can we expect from both companies?
I think you're going to see the biggest fight between AMD and NVIDIA we've seen in quite a while. They hinted at, you know, they got punchy last year, and they did all the back end work. I think this is the year that you'll see AMD come out swinging at NVIDIA, giving everything they've got, all guns blazing. This is just the opening shot. It's going to get bigger.
Evan, what do you reckon?
I agree with Al. I think it's going to be a very, very good year. And this is only good for consumers. This is only good for us. Having two very competitive companies going at it is going to make it a very good year for PC gamers, I think.
Fantastic. It's exciting stuff. Thank you very much for watching, and let us know where you stand on the NVIDIA versus AMD debate in the comments below, or tweet us at Trusted Reviews.